ChatGPT can't multiply. Look, I'll give it two numbers and ask them to multiply them. And if we compare the output to a calculator, it's wrong. So why does ChatGPT fail at something that computers have been doing easily since we've had computers? The clue might be in the appearance. The first few digits are right and the last few digits are right, but it got confused somewhere in the middle. So why does this happen? The way that ChatGPT answers you is by making predictions based off of text that it's seen before. It doesn't actually understand what it's doing, but it has seen lots of multiplication problems before. Statistically, it knows that seeing two numbers end with a 7 and a 2 with a time sign in between is going to result in a number that ends with a 4. Similarly, it can make statistical observations for the start of two numbers multiplied together. But the middle digits of a product depend on all of the digits of the input, and that's going to be a lot more complicated. It can't get away with just simple statistical observations. From ChatGPT's perspective, the middle digits might as well be random. So current large language models like ChatGPT are pretty far from beating mathematicians. But despite this, AI is currently being used by mathematicians to do research. One of the coolest ways that AI is used to do math research is with what's called a SAT solver. This is used to solve what's called the Boolean satisfiability question. And no, I don't know why SAT is in all caps. Maybe we should be calling it a SAT solver. This software looks at sentences like this. We want to substitute the words true and false in for the variables, and then apply these reduction rules to make it spit out true. A SAT solver tells us if it's possible to do this. Normally, checking every possibility would take an exponential amount of time as the number of variables grow, but modern SAT solvers have gotten really good, and in practice, with their heuristics and optimizations, can solve sentences with thousands of variables. There are some math problems that can be converted into smallish Boolean sentences, and then you just let the SAT solver take care of the rest. A particularly famous example of a SAT solver being used in math research was in 2016, when one was used to resolve the Boolean Pythagorean triples problem. This problem asks if you can color the positive integers red and blue so that no Pythagorean triple is either all red or all blue. The answer is no, and the 68GB proof was generated after 2 days of computation by a SAT solver. SAT solvers are a powerful tool in the mathematician's tool belt, but they aren't going to replace mathematicians. It takes clever work to convert a problem into a short Boolean sentence. And besides, a lot of problems that mathematicians work on can't be converted. SAT solvers are a form of AI that can be used to solve a very particular type of question. But what about techniques like neural networks that have become more synonymous with AI in recent years? Can AI techniques like neural networks be used to do pure math research? A really cool paper by Adam Wagner did just this, when he used neural networks to find counterexamples to several problems in combinatorics. He generated counterexamples to the conjectures using a technique called the cross-entropy method. Here's how it works. Imagine that you have some conjecture about graphs, but you're not sure how to test it. You could write code to test every possible graph, but that'd be horribly inefficient. Instead, you want to write code that generates graphs, but in a smarter way. Essentially, what this technique does is it trains a neural net on some graphs to predict how to build a graph for the problem. Then it builds graphs that it predicts are likely to be counterexamples to the conjecture. It makes a ton of these, and then it computes which ones were actually closest to disproving the conjecture. And then it retrains the neural net based off of those graphs. The hope is that over time, it's going to make graphs closer and closer to disproving the conjecture until it finds one that actually works. This is a really cool technique, and I imagine it could save mathematicians a lot of time from trying to prove false conjectures. I think it'd also be really interesting to see other AI techniques used in pure math research to find examples that no human would ever have the time to. I don't think AI is likely to replace mathematicians during my lifetime, but I'm eager to see it become another tool in the mathematician's tool belt.